Hey guys, so I had a few requests for a volley tutorial. Thanks to Tom G and to Lives That Inspire for your suggestions. This is for you too and anybody else that wants to improve their volleys. In this video, I will talk you through 5 tips that I like to use to improve your volleys, and if you hang around to the end, there'll be a bonus one too. Whether you're a doubles player or a singles player, the volley is a crucial part in your game. If you play singles, you don't hit as many volleys, but when you do, it's at a crucial time. It's a chance to finish the point. But if you're a doubles player, you're going to hit those volleys in a lot more volume, so being better at them is going to be a big part of your game. The nice thing about the volley is it's probably one of the most simple shots. However, it's the most rushed shot because we have a lot less time to react. So these next tips will help you to be more efficient when you're at the net and more confident to get into the net with your volleys. So the first and most obvious thing to make your volleys better is to set up correctly. So first thing we need to know is the grip. Now for volleys, we need to use the chopper grip. The reason we use the chopper grip is because it allows you to make contact with your forehand volley and your backhand volley without making the grip change. When you're at the net, most of the time you don't have time to make any changes to your grip, so a continental or chopper grip is going to be the most efficient way to volley on both sides. Once you've got the chopper grip, you need to make sure that you're setting up with your racket head above your grip. So I like to use my spare hand, my left hand, to hold the neck of the racket, and that helps to keep my racket head up high. The reason we want the racket head to be above the grip is because we want to make contact with the ball above the height of the net as much as possible. It's much more difficult to make a good volley if the ball is dropping beneath the height of the net, so holding that racket head up is going to help massively. And finally, in your ready position, once you've got the grip and the setup with your hands and the racket in the right position, you want to make sure that you've got a nice wide base with your feet, a good knee bend, and a good way to visualize this is trying to hide your grip underneath the net tape. So if you get into this position here, it's going to make you nice and athletic and ready to pounce into your forehand and backhand volleys. When you're in your ready position, it's important to remember that your racket needs to be in a neutral position. I often see people looking quite casual at the net with their racket here, but you can clearly see that the racket is on my backhand side, so it's going to take longer for me to get my racket over to my forehand if it comes this way. So being in a very neutral position is going to give you an equal opportunity to take your forehand and your backhand volley. The second way to hit better volleys is to make sure that your racket face or your strings go to the ball first. Now, when we're at the baseline, we have a bit more time to react. So we often focus on getting our feet into the right position as we take the racket back. But when we're at the net volleying, we don't often have the time to move our feet first. So the priority is to get your strings behind the ball as soon as you can. As soon as you've done that, your feet will follow. So if the ball comes in to a comfortable position, you can get your strings right behind the ball and step in through it. If the ball is slightly wider, you'll see that if your strings go first, your feet will naturally follow to help you to make a good contact on the ball. And if that ball comes straight at you, of course you want to get the strings behind the ball first so that you can then step away and make a good contact. But when that ball comes in towards you, you need to prioritize getting your strings behind the ball first. The third thing to consider in making your volleys better is going to the ball or meeting the ball. Now, as I said before, it's much easier to hit a good volley when you make contact with the ball above the height of the net. It's incredibly difficult to hit an effective shot if your racket's dropping beneath the height of the net. So make sure you keep your racket head up. And to do that, we need to make sure that we take the ball as early as possible. So if I'm stood back here and that ball's floating in, rather than waiting for the ball to come to me with the risk of it dropping down low, I want to come forward to meet the ball before it drops beneath the height of the net. The earlier you can take your volley in any situation, the better. So try to be proactive in going to the ball and hunting it down. A good phrase or word that I like to use with the kids when working with them is meet balls. Okay, you've got to meet the ball. Don't wait for the ball, it's your job to go to it. So don't stand there waiting for the ball. Always expect it to come to you, especially when you're playing doubles. Always expect it to come to you and go to the ball as soon as you see it do so. Tip number 4 for your volley is to have a compact swing. Now, the reason we want to have a compact swing is, again, because we are limited with the amount of time that we have to react. So if you have a big take back on your forehand or backhand volley, by the time the ball is at you, you're going to be meeting the ball late. So by having a very compact swing and just taking your racket string behind the ball and pushing forwards, you're going to be a lot more efficient with your time and you're going to be able to make a much better contact point. if you swing too big, you're going to catch the ball later and it will spray out into different directions. A nice way that I teach the kids for this one is to try to avoid taking your racket behind your ear and past your nose. So you've got to try and keep the racket within this quarter. Okay? You'll see when I do my volleys in the demonstration that my swing's slightly bigger, and that's just because I've got a bit more time and I'm trying to put a little bit more power onto the volley. But you can still see that it doesn't have a follow through, it's very punchy and short, so the more compact you can be with the volley, the more control that you'll have over it. My final tip for having better volleys is to make more use of your non-dominant hand. So for me, that would be my left hand. So as I mentioned in the setup, you want to try to hold the neck of your racket with your spare hand to ensure that the racket head stays up. But also, equally importantly, is when we swing to the ball, our spare hand should be counterbalancing and helping us to be more balanced through the shot. On the forehand, as we take the racket back to prepare behind the ball, our hands separate. So you'll see as I go to the ball, my hands separate, and as I go to meet the ball, my hands will come together. However, on the backhand side, we'll do the opposite. So the hands stay together on the take back. I'm guiding the racket back, keeping it stable, and the racket head up. But as I meet the ball, my hands will split. So on the forehand side, they come together. On the backhand side, my hands split. And this will help me to keep a good center of gravity, good balance, and a little bit more energy and crispness through the volley. Give that a try. So my bonus tip for you and your volleys is to squeeze the racket as you make contact. Now, a very common thing that you hear coaches say to players is to have a looser grip, and they're not wrong. In general, in forehands and backhands and serving, it's very good to have a loose grip because it allows you to be very fluid with your swings and to get a little bit more energy and flow through the shot. However, when I hit my volleys, I start off with a loose grip. I prepare my racket with a nice, loose, relaxed grip because I don't want to squeeze my forearm too early. But as I make contact with the ball, that's when I'll squeeze and I'll have a slightly tighter grip as I go to meet the ball. I feel that it gives me a little bit more force behind the ball and it makes me direct the ball into where I want it to go because I've got a lot more control over the racket head when I just squeeze at contact. So give that one a try and let me know how you get on with it. So there you have it. There are 5 ways that you can make your volleys better, plus the bonus one at the end. Now, I don't want you to go out there thinking about all of those tips all in one go, because it will go horribly wrong. But if you can just take one of those things, take it onto the court next time you practice your volleys, or the next time you're in a doubles match, have a go. Let me know if you found any of these tips useful, or if you've come across any other areas that you found that have helped your volleys in play. Thanks again for your video suggestions, and if you are watching this and you have something in your game that you're not that happy with or you'd like to get better at, let me know in the comments below and I will add it to my list of videos to make. And if you are new here and you haven't subscribed yet, click that button below, and if you click the bell as well, you'll get a notification when my next video comes out, so you can keep up to date with everything that I put on YouTube. Take care.